Good evening. Welcome to ThaiPBS English News Service. I'm Super John Klinsuan. Worried that the cost of living, especially food items, will jump sky high, the Minister of Commerce is not allowing the retail palm oil price to exceed 42 baht per litre, despite admitting the fact that the cost of palm oil manufacturing is higher than the current limit. The latest round of raw palm oil hikes saw an increase of 30% from 4 baht 80 stang to 6 baht 20 stang per kilogram. This new market price, according to palm oil manufacturers, will mean a cost to them of 50 baht to produce 1 liter of palm oil. The Commerce Ministry, however, maintains its pegged price of 42 baht per liter. Yeah, Pirom admits these figures will hurt operators, but the ministry will keep the limit and will assist instead in finding raw materials at a lower price. The government is now worried the cost of living will drive up inflation. The Commerce Minister insists there is still sufficient palm oil in stock to serve demand. Those caught stockpiling or selling retail palm oil beyond the limited price will face legal action. While the specifications and price of the one tablet per child policy was expected to be announced today, once again the announcement was postponed. However, the education minister insists that the computer tablets will be delivered to first grade students by May when the school starts again. Meanwhile, Kun Pawut Pong Wittianu, vice president of the Thai E-Commerce Association, told Dr. Rungtip Chonnaphalai that buying the hardware is not as worrying as repairing the right software.
We give the hardware to them, but we have to think about, okay, how about the software, how about the people, where the people are going to use that, or the teacher, they understand how to use the tablet much or not, okay. But another thing, that is another thing, is software. Now they plan to have a 5 application in the tablet, okay, but I'm not sure what is 5 enough or not. And when they have application, they're going to use it. How they're going to use it? They're going to use it like a one, you know, the whole session, or you know, just, you know, one session, the whole class. That is the thing that I'm still concerned about. Mm-hmm.
So you think that computer tablets, is it good or bad for kids, for students?
I think it's good, okay. But it depends on the service that we have in here. If you have a lot of games, too much entertainment, it's maybe not good for them, okay. That means we have to do something to protecting, to let them know that, okay, they have to use in the right way. And in the another way that, okay, the people that give it to the children, they have to know that. If sometimes they not know that, something like an old teacher, they sometimes they just can use a little bit, okay? And then, you know, they give it to the children. Sometimes children is better than, you know, the clever, more clever than teacher. I mean, the teacher don't know anything. But then
because it's their generation to use technology, right?
And they can do something like play games, a teacher never know that. That's thing that, okay, we have to beware about that.
The tsunami that hit Japan and the floods that inundated Thailand respectively last year forced a dramatic reduction in local automobile production to 400,000 vehicles below target, causing Thailand to slip in the world ranking from 12th to the 14th. Meanwhile, the automotive industry club aims to manufacture 2.1 million vehicles this year.
The Automotive Industry Club believes that Thailand can manufacture 2.1 million vehicles this year, as well as increase production by 38% in the next 5 years. The group aims to hit 3 million vehicles per year once Thailand joins ASEAN Economic Community in 2015. Suparat Siri Suwanakun, president of the club, said that the Thai automotive industry remains robust, especially in production of pickup trucks and eco cars, the latter being the number one selling vehicles in the country. Despite an expansion in Indonesia's eco-car market, Suparat believes that sales of local eco-cars will be left unaffected, as they are of higher quality than standard Euro 4. While Thailand continues to face challenges in productivity and higher labor costs, the automotive industry looks set to turn more local manufactured vehicles into hybrids in the next 5 to 10 years. Mom Rashawong Pongsawat Sawadiwat, Minister of Industry, indicated that automotive exports account for 360 billion baht and the industry employs as many as 350,000 workers. Thailand aims to become the leader in automotive production in ASEAN and rank among the top 10 automotive manufacturing countries in the world. Many Japanese car manufacturers remain confident in Thailand and planned to continue their local investments for the next 3 to 5 years, totaling 100 billion baht.
Still related to the flood issue, the National Science and Technology Development Agency has come up with an innovation that will help Thailand prevail over the 2012 floods. However, the Minister of Science is quite confident that massive floods will not hit Thailand this year. And what you see here is called the N-sac, made of polymer gel. These sacks will absorb water 100 times its original volume within 45 minutes. This is one of the brainchild projects of the National Science and Technology Development Agency, or what Thais would refer to as Sawwatashaw. Among the other innovations from the agency are a floating house, an ultrasonic flood depth measuring machine, and much more. These gadgets will be showcased at the Fighting Floods with Science and Technology exhibition, held between March 24th and 28th at the Thailand Science Park, located in Pathum Thani, which is one of the worst flooded provinces last year. Meanwhile, Plabasop Surasawadi, Minister of Science, who will be distributing some of these inventions to locals living in flood-prone areas, says that after receiving essential information and studies from Denmark and the Netherlands, the government will be much better prepared and equipped to solve this year's floods. He says that there's only a 1% chance that Thailand will see a repeat of the 2011 floods again in 2012, if there were to be floods, he's confident that the duration of the floods will be shorter and of a lower quantity than last year. At least 17 provinces are now home to drought-struck areas, especially provinces in the north and northeastern regions. Farmers in Chaiyaphum province have called on state officials to stop blocking water from the natural water sources in order to produce tap water, as their crops will likely die soon.
The rice farmers in Phu district of Chaiyaphum province are accusing the local administration of hoarding water for use in other districts as tap water. They are now being affected by drought conditions as the amount of water in Lahan Marsh, the natural water source for agriculture uses, has now reduced to only 17 million cubic meters, or 30% of the marsh normal capacity. The ad hoc committee on this case decided to open one of four sluice gates once every 3 days to release 1 million cubic meters of water for agricultural uses each time, while the water remaining in Lahan Marsh will be used to produce tap water. Meanwhile, the corn farmers in Mueang district in Sisket province decided to harvest the corn 2 days ahead of the schedule to avoid damage from the drought, as the amount of water in Hue San reservoirs has significantly decreased to only 60% of the reservoir's storage capacity. The reservoir is now unable to release the water to the cornfields. Moreover, pests have spread across the double crop fields in Khuang Nai and Warin Chamrap district in Ubon Ratchathani province, and the local agriculture department says using an insecticide is only one way to eliminate the pest.
Opposition MPs within Parliament's National Reconciliation Subcommittee still question whether the amnesty for all political players will really result in a more peaceful Thailand. Meanwhile, the Constitution Draft Amendment Committee concluded that the Council of the State and the Election Commission of Thailand will also help seek the Constitution drafters. Parliament's Constitution Draft Amendment Subcommittee finally concluded that on top of the MPs and senators, certain members of the Election Commission and Office of the Council of State will help with writing the list of qualifications for the 2012 Constitution drafters. This, according to the committee, is to create a transparent process. Meanwhile, Nipit Intarasombat, a Democrat MP who is a member of the Parliament's National Reconciliation Subcommittee, is asking the Paboklao Institute to prove that its findings are genuine after the think tank stated that amnesty for all political players is essential to create a more peaceful and understanding Thailand. The opposition Democrat MPs, who are in a minority on this committee, are worried that a total amnesty will bring former Prime Minister and fugitive Thaksin Shinawat back to Thailand as a free man. Meanwhile, Air Chief Marshal Sukampon Suanathat, the defense minister who is a classmate of former PM Thaksin, says that he personally believes that Thaksin is man enough that he will not obstruct the national reconciliation process for his own personal benefit. Burmese kitchenware is extremely popular among locals along the Thai-Myanmar border. However, Umphang Hospital of Tak Province is warning citizens to stop using old Burmese pots and pans as they are believed to be the reason behind an increase in the level of lead being detected in local residents' blood. Burmese who reside in Tak Province along the Thai-Myanmar border prefer to use rice cooking pots from their country. However, many remain unaware of the kitchenware's poisonous lead content, and they continue cooking with these utensils. As for Nan Province along the Thai-Laos border, many kitchenware merchants admitted that they are unsure if their products are hazardous to health or not, but they said that most Thai consumers purchase Thai-made kitchenware because they are of better quality. The outcry about the safety of kitchenware arose after Umphang Hospital of Tak Province discovered that lead levels detected in a villager's blood, including children, have exceeded safety standards for many years. Physicians believe that the high levels of lead are a result of worn-out Burmese kitchenware. This is because lead is exposed when these utensils have been in use for a long time. Lead is harmful to human health and can cause growth and brain disorders in children. Umphang Hospital is now working with head villagers to inform locals of the problem and to discourage them from using such kitchenware. The smoke haze, which has been affecting 10 provinces in the north for several weeks, has almost been completely gone now due to the recent non-stop rain. However, despite tough measures to prevent farmers from burning, some are still lighting fires. Some farmers in Chiang Rai are still burning their rice fields to prepare their land for the next planting season. Even though constant rain has now reduced the problem, these fires caused the airborne particles levels to rise above safe levels for many days. The Director General of the Protected Area General Office said that even if the level of pollution have reduced, officials must continue to closely control the situation as farmers may resume the burning after the rain stops. He also admitted that the haze crisis this year has been made worse by the burning from last year. Lieutenant General Wanatip Wong Wai says that the Army has joined with the leaders of local communities to educate people about the effects caused by farm burnings and sent soldiers to help officials extinguish fires. He added that he believed that the artificial rainmaking process would help reduce the haze. This year, there have been 1,300 reported wildfires, which damaged approximately 9,000 rai of land. However, the Pollution Control Department recently reported that haze pollution in 9 upper northern provinces has, for the moment anyway, almost completely gone. And we're going to end tonight with an end credit. As many Thais that are saying that once they enter the work industry, they will not have any chance to exercise. A owner of a garment factory here in Bangkok is supporting his staffs to exercise even though they are still at their workstations. And that brings us to the end of tonight's edition of Thai PBS English News Service. I'm Supachon Kinsuwan signing out. See you again tomorrow. Sawadee krap.